Hello students, welcome back. I Professor P.M. Vibhute. Welcome to the next session on Basic Electrical and Electronics Engineering. We are discussing about an DC circuit, and today's topic of discussion is series and parallel combination of resistors. Now, we already know that what is series and parallel combination of resistor. When your resistors are connected one after another in such a fashion which is shown in figure, then this combination is known as a series combination of resistor. And whenever the resistors are connected in this particular fashion, when both the ends of resistors connected together, then that is known as a parallel fashion. Now, let me tell you how to identify whether it is a series combination or parallel combination. See, for example, in this particular figure, only one terminal of R1 and R2 is common, whereas the second terminal of R1 and R2 is safe or connected to this different point. Means we can say one terminal of R1 and R2 are at equal potential, then that combination is known as a series combination. Whereas when both the terminal of the resistors are at the equipotential, for example, see over here, R1 and R2 and R3, the one terminal of R1, R2, R3 are connected together, whereas second terminal is also connected together, then this particular combination is known as parallel combination. Now, how to calculate an equivalent resistor in resistance in series combination? So, simple formula is R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. For example, take a case like R1 is 10 ohm, R2 is 10 ohm and R3 is 10 ohm. Then effective resistor across this particular point, let call it as a point A and this as a point B, then resistance across point A and B is nothing but addition of resistance of all three resistances. So, that's why R equivalent or RAB will be equal to 10 plus 10 plus 10. So that comes up to be 30 ohm. Please mind, resistance had a unit of ohms. So whenever we say it is 10, 10, 10, it is nothing but 10 ohm, 10 ohm and 10 ohm. Now, similarly, whenever resistors are connected in parallel, the formula is something like this. Let me rewrite this particular formula in a simple way, that is 1 upon R equivalent is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2 plus 1 upon R3 and so on. Now, here, number of resistor connected parallel will contribute to this particular parallel combination. So, that's why this particular series will continue if we have more number of resistor. Now, let's take the same case again. If it is a 10 ohm, if it is again 10 ohm and 10 ohm, means all three resistors are of value 10 ohm, then how much is an equivalent resistor? So, 1 upon R equivalent, again, let's consider this point as a point A and this point as a point B. So, how much is an equivalent resistance across point A and B? So, 1 upon R equivalent is equal to 1 upon 10 plus 1 upon 10 plus 1 upon 10. Now, you can see that as denominator is same, so that's why we can consider this R equivalent as, I'm writing it over here, 1 upon R equivalent is equal to 3 by 10, right? Because denominator is same and that's why numerator will get added together. Now, we need to take a reciprocal or we need to invert this particular equation to find out the value of R equivalent. So, that's why R equivalent will be equal to 10 by 3 and that is something around 3.33 ohms. So, this is an equivalent resistance whenever we connected a three resistance of same value together. Now, this is about how we can calculate a series and parallel combination of resistor. Now, let me give you one simple trick. Whenever a two resistor or multiple resistor of same value are connected in series, what will happen? This is one of the very important type of a question, because whenever we connect a number of resistor of same value, then for example, I connected x number of resistors of same value, then equivalent resistor will be x into value of individual resistor. Let me call it as a R ohm. So, equivalent resistor will be x into R ohm. Similarly, whenever we connect an x number of resistors of same value in parallel, again x resistors of same value in parallel combination, then what will be an equivalent value? So, equivalent value will be R divided by x. The equivalent will be value will be R divided by X. Like in previous case, we are having an three resistors of value 10, means X is equal to 3 and R is equal to 10. So that's why in series combination we calculated it as a 30 ohm. Am I right? Because our answer is matching with the previous one. This is correct. Then in parallel combination, it was 10 divided by 3 and that comes up to be 33.33. So this is also matching with our previous answer. So remember this particular T. Whenever a resistors of same values are connected in series, then just multiply the equivalent value can be calculated by multiplying and value of resistor by number of resistors. Similarly, if number of resistors connected in parallel, equivalent value can be calculated by dividing the amount of or value of that particular resistor by number of resistor. So, this is a tip. Now, let's solve one more numerical to understand how series parallel combination work. Now see, I am taking over here as an example over here. The question is, calculate an equivalent resistance across A and B. Calculate an equivalent resistance across A and B. Now pause this video over here and calculate an equivalent value and tell me in a chat box. Okay, now let's proceed. I hope you have tried this particular numerical. So we have three resistors connected over here. Now let's first of all find out this 5 ohm resistor and this 5 ohm resistor, whether they are in series or in parallel. Very simple trick, I already told you, check whether one terminal is common or both terminal are common. One thing which is visible and you can see with the naked eye is that one terminal of both these resistors are common, but see the second terminal of this particular 5 ohm is connected over here, and second terminal of 5 ohm is connected over here, means they are not connected together. You can see that between those two terminals there is a 10 ohm resistor. Means what? This 5 ohm resistor, these both resistors are in series combination. Now we know that the formula for calculating R equivalent in series, R equivalent is equal to R1 plus R2. Now how much is R1? R1 is 5 ohm and R2 is 5 ohm. So total comes up together 10 ohm. So R equivalent across this particular two points are 10 ohm. Now let me draw this particular circuit again. Now you can see that this 10 ohm is as it is, and equivalent resistor that we calculated of these two resistors is 10 ohm. So this is something like 10 ohm and this is again 10 ohm. Now this is point A and this is point B. Now again, for these two resistors of 10 ohm, let's calculate an equivalent resistor. For that, identify whether they are in series or parallel. Again, see that over here, one terminal of both these resistors are common. It can be viewed by naked eyes, and same, the second terminal is also connected together. Means these two resistors of 10 ohm are connected in parallel. But this time, rather than solving, I will ask you to refer a tip. What was the tip? Tip says that when two resistors of same value are connected in parallel, equivalent resistance is half of the, or we can say equivalent resistor can be calculated by value of resistor divided by number of resistor. Value of resistor is 10 ohm divided by number of resistor. How many number of resistors are there? 2. So that's why this comes up to be 5 ohm. So that's why we calculated a resistance across this particular point A and B. So that is why we can say RAB is equal to 5 ohm. So this is how I elaborated the concept of series and parallel combination. In this video, we have discussed about three important tips: how to identify whether connection is series, how to identify whether the connection is parallel, that is whether one terminal is common or both terminal are common, and third tip that we discussed about what happens whenever a resistor of same value come together. Like for example, same value resistor connected in series and same value resistors connected in parallel. So that's it for a day. So I hope you understood how to calculate an equivalent resistor in series and parallel combination. We will discuss few more examples in next lecture. Thank you.